Patron in a glass of wine. Patron is a nice cigar.
See, Byron's nice got the cigar. Byron's Patron the one who's got the real suggestion.
Byron said Patron and I had flashbacks to New Year's Eve.
That is going to be a good game tonight. We'll talk about that a little later in the show. James Harden continuing to carry the Rockets in Chris Paul's absence on Monday. Harden had 43 points, triple-double, win over the Grizzlies over the last 10 games. Yes, you heard that right. James Harden averaging more than 40 a game. So look, he wins MVP last season, right? Took him a few years to do it. He was a finalist a couple years, finally breaks through. Then they have those playoffs where Chris Paul goes down. He could not single-handedly push the Rockets past the Warriors. Now, there's no shame in that.
He was excellent in the playoffs.
He was excellent.
Right. Yeah, right.
But once he was sort of unable to do that, you heard a lot of people saying, oh, well, they're not going to give him an MVP again until he shows that he could do something like that. Guess what? He's putting up MVP numbers again.
Yeah, I think the biggest thing for him, though, is they've got to dig out of the hole that they started this season with. They're getting there, but
they're what, tied for fourth in the West?
That's still not going to be good enough when you look at Milwaukee's record and what Giannis is doing. When you look at what the Lakers are doing when LeBron gets back, what Kawhi Leonard, you know, so that's the problem. He's going to have to overcome guys who are also putting up phenomenal stats, but our teams have more success, not because they're better per se, but because they didn't start the year in this massive hole that Houston's trying to dig themselves out of.
I think if he gets them back to that second seed in the Western Conference and he continues to put up these type numbers or even close to it, I mean, it's going to be hard for him to play this way for the remainder of the season and average 40 points a game. But if he averages 30 or something like that and they get to the second seed, which we all thought that's where they would be anyway at the beginning of the season, I think he is unanimous MVP.
I mean, you know my concern is if he keeps this pace up.
He's going to be hurt too. He could maybe be more in the MVP conversation than people thought.
But then we've seen it. He pushes himself so hard sometimes during the regular season. That he does run out of gas toward the end of the postseason. And I don't know. Once you are safely in the playoffs, and I don't think they're going to miss the playoffs. Like, I just think they're going to get their act together enough that they're not going to miss the playoffs. And I would be a little more cautious with holding him at times through the regular season.
But Rachel, if you look at
him, he's already got an MVP. He doesn't need to win another one.
Yeah, but if you look at them right now and the way they're playing and the amount of games they are back from being the first seed, you got to go for it.
Man.
You got to go for it. I mean, you got to go for it.
We talked about this before. It's like, what's the alternative? That he doesn't do it and they probably miss the playoffs. Like,
there's got to be a middle ground here.
I don't know if there's a middle ground. Not with the injuries that they're dealing with. If they're less than 100%, he has to be out there that much for them to be able.
I do think you look at that chart. Don't sleep on Kawhi Leonard. Because
no doubt about it.
Absolutely.
No doubt about it.